Assalamu alaikum and good morning, dear friends. Yesterday, on a private TV channel, it was written stuff regarding a case under review in the Supreme Court of Pakistan. In which it was narrated that Chief Justice of Pakistan Justice Saqib he is of the view that legislation of federal legislature can be reviewed. And that is a good omen for Pakistan, because Pakistan is a federation. And if Supreme Court extends its jurisdiction of judicial review or executive orders, the executive heads of Pakistan and or on legislature as well, then the checks will be there. And nobody will be having absolute power. It tends to corrupt absolutely. Because it is being said by an ancient political philosopher. Power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. All those who are having some, we are not supposed to suspect or doubt the intentions of those who were including parliamentary form of government with absolute majority rule in a federation like Pakistan. I don't think that they will be having that idea in their mind in this way. They will be able to hold absolute power and do corrupt practices. Maybe they were not so aware of the effects of giving absolute power to the parliament. Federation. Maybe they made their constitution in a hurry. Many authentic sources they have told me that J. Rahim was the main architect of the 1973 constitution for Pakistan. Though he never got the credit for it and he was forced into exile by his friends trying to take the credit for making the constitution. In the larger national interest, I can add some more favorable arguments make the Federation more acceptable for all its component units. Right now we are in 5 problems in Federation. Well, Justice John Marshall, while coming up with the argument that implied meanings of certain constitutional provisions they provide for power of judicial review of the U.S. Supreme Court. Thus, he had started exercising check upon executive orders of the President of USA and legislation made by Congress as well. If you look into the nature of Pakistan's constitution, it provides for a federal setup. Obviously, it implies that there will be a power of judicial review with Supreme Court, because already in a classic example of a federation, which is the United States of America, that power of judicial review is there with the U.S. Supreme Court. I think that already our Chief Justice, our Supreme Court, is having that power to determine the constitutionality of executive orders of the President and Prime Minister, and to determine the constitutionality of legislation. Well, as we know, that in U.S. Federation, cabinet ministers of the U.S. President are mostly technocrats, and they are not elected people. They are mostly members of the party of the president elect, but these cabinet members are not elected entities. They are technocrats mostly, and they are the party members of the president of USA, and once they are nominated by him as his cabinet secretaries, then after approval from the Senate, they start working in the best interest of USA and its people. So they have included education at every level. Technocrats are mostly educated people, okay? And they are there in the cabinet of President of USA. We Pakistanis, we are also having a federal setup. So now, in a given system with parliamentary democracy, we can only bring education in through Supreme Court, through its power of judicial review. some learned judges are always sitting there, whom are exercising check upon the authority of our executive heads, and are there to determine the constitutionality of their executive orders, and they are also there to determine the constitutionality of legislative measures. And their education can help us develop and strengthen this federation. Right now we don't have that provision. Our Prime Minister's cabinet is formed of the people who are elected in their constituencies and are members of his party. And mostly they are technocrats. As if we peek into history, he will come to know some of them were appointed as cabinet ministers by prime ministers as they were their partners in jail because they were struggling for their partyhood. Though they mostly terminated their struggle for democracy, but actually they don't have any democracy within their political parties. They all are having fascist mindset, and they all ignore the provisions of the constitution after coming into power. So what we can do is that we can get some benefit of those learned people who are sitting there in Supreme Court and can improve the lot of our people and can strengthen the federation as well. Can minimize the conflict by this way. I don't know whether there will be a will in society that educated ones shall rule us and shall help us to improve our lot. Because right now, we are having very very odd trends. Even those trends are visible in India as well since long. People, they do feel happy when an ignorant person having no education becomes a minister, when such person becomes elected member of a parliament, then people, they really feel happy, and the media, they project all that as a heroic victory of an ignorant man who has become a minister and who has been elected by the people. They term it as victory of the people. And they never come up with a true analysis that if we fill the parliament with all the ignorance, there will be no change for better. The situation will become worse. Now you see, we are having educated people here in our parliament to a larger extent. And the situation is this, that they are just ignoring the constitution. last 2 decades or so, elected prime ministers with their elected members of the cabinet, they had ignored the constitution. They had resorted to discrimination. They had done everything which was possible in terms of unconstitutional practices. And no one was ever checked by the Supreme Court. Only twice Prime Minister Gilani was checked by the Supreme Court and was ousted from power. And then Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif is recently disqualified. On grounds that he was holding another office of profit with a foreign firm. He's a comma holder and an employee of his son's organization. This is unconstitutional. Being an executive head of Pakistan, you can hold only one office. That is a prime minister. President, cabinet minister, and still we are having a good number of comma holders as our ministers, and probably our existing prime minister is also a comma holder. Sheikh Khatam Abbasi, I'm not sure about that. They should have resigned from their jobs abroad before becoming the president or prime minister. President is not a comma holder. There is no such allegation against him. We are having 81 comma holders who are having resident status, jobs. It is clearly written in Constitution that no other office of profit can be held by the public figures, elected representatives of Pakistan. So this is what is going on, and that is because of the absence of sufficient checks and balances within the system. And even if certain checks and balances are there, the will, the political will, is lacking. And the people are not aware regarding the constitution. And because of prevailing large-scale ignorance here, people, they do not admire education, or they don't trust educated people, or they are being indoctrinated in a way that they hate education, they dislike education, they dislike educated people, they don't trust education. I do sit with them, I do talk to them, commoners, and they have developed that lack of trust. Because of the cruel practices, because of the thuggery and deception of successive leaders who came to exploit them in name of democracy while promoting their hidden fascist, Nazi or communist agendas in the past. So to reach to the stage where the parliament in Pakistan can make certain amendments and additions to have one executive head in Pakistan, because right now we are having two executive heads. The president of Pakistan is also having executive powers. Prime Minister is also head of executive. Here we are supposed to make a correction. Then we have to extend jurisdiction of Supreme Court of its power of judiciary or executive head. Constitutionality of the executive orders of the president or prime minister, whosoever is the executive head, can be determined by the Supreme Court. So an educated judge, if you are having an ignorant person as our executive head, the Supreme Court is there to correct. So our people will not suffer so much as they are suffering right now. And even if our parliament is filled with ignorant people, the majority will be unable to do any harm in case Supreme Court is having a check for the legislation of our federal. And for provincial legislations as well. So right now we are having this option before us. And I think that Justice Saqib or Supreme Court of Pakistan as institution, being an institution of a federation, is having that power. The implied meanings of a federation, of a federal setup, gives that power to Pakistan to exercise a check upon executive orders of the executive heads of Pakistan and legislative measures taken by. I wish all the best to all of you.